అందరికీ నమస్కారం. నమస్కారం టు ఎవ్రీ వన్. థ్యాంక్ యూ మాండలిన్ రాజేష్ జీ, థ్యాంక్ యూ ప్రవీణ్ జీ, వెల్కమ్ బ్యాక్ టు హీలింగ్ మాండలిన్.
నమస్తే టు ఎవ్రీ వన్. వెరీ హ్యాపీ గురు పూర్ణిమ. ఇట్స్ అ వెరీ స్పెషల్ అండ్ ఇంపార్టెంట్ డే ఫర్ ఆల్ ఆఫ్ అస్, ఎస్పెషలీ ఫర్ మీ, బికాస్ వితౌట్ గురుస్ బ్లెస్సింగ్స్ దేర్ ఇస్ నథింగ్ ఇన్ అవర్ లైఫ్, బికాస్ గురు ఇస్ ద వన్ హూ గైడ్స్ యూ అండ్ షోస్ ద రైట్ పాత్. Madhu garu, over to you. Thank you.
Thank you.
What I'll do is, I'll after you speak, I'll start with Ganesh Vandanam, and then we'll go ahead from there.
Definitely. Happy Guru Purnima to everybody. We want to keep this musical melody flowing through our ears. Pray to Guru, the masters who gave us education, to mother, father, teachers, to great masters, this song. Thank you, sir. Over to you, sir. Amazing, sir. They say, I would say, Srinivasam Smarami. Sri Srinivasam Smarami. On this auspicious day of Guru Purnima, we want to remember, thank and do pranams to Lord Venkateshwara, who is Srinivas, and Mandalin Srinivas ji, your Guruji, our Guruji. Probably we should start with Rajesh sir saying something about Annai Garu. He is your guru, brother, and a guru for Carnatic music, a tradition on an instrument itself, and inspiration to others, many, many others like us.
First of all, very happy to see all the students. Very happy Guru Purnima to all of them. what to say? It is a blessing to have a guru like our God, you Srinivas ji, and it's a added blessings to be a brother and also disciple. For me, guru doesn't mean only he teaches some art or something. Anybody who has given you some advice or things which have changed your life, they're also your gurus. I consider everyone. Thank you, Madhugaru. A lot of people in my life, Guru, Kanji Paramacharya, Satya Sai Baba. Because I think without gurus or gurus' blessings or gurus' guidance, life is completely lost. And it is very, very important to understand your guru. Even he might have taught you just one lesson or maybe one day class, but a guru is a guru. If you have paripurna bhakti to your guru and if you have paripurna blessings of your guru, even if you play or your performance is very bad, the guru's blessings will make you sound you are great and he will push take you to heights. That's what I believe. This is my belief.
Very nice, sir. Wonderful, sir. I want to add a few things about guru. Parameshwaraya Namaha. Carnatic music is one of the greatest examples of guru parampara in the world. To all the music lovers, you are fortunate because Carnatic music came from guru to sishya, sishya to again next sishya to sishya. That tradition has been coming for generations. An example where guru is essential, it is music. It's Indian music. Second thing is Vedas. Vedas came from guru to sishya parampara. Smritis. The days when there were no papers, there were no digital recordings. People just remembered the mantras. Yopam pushpam veda pushpavan prajavan pashuman bhavat. When they say the mantra, it is remembered. Tacham yora vrunimahe gatum yajnaya gatum yajnapataye. They remembered. The mantra is remembered. The pronunciation is remembered. We are unable to pronounce that accurately. People like me, as because we did not have that in-person guru training and parampara. As you said, sir, it does not matter. Guru is not a person or a human being. He is the manifestation, murti of the entire knowledge. And today, on this auspicious day of Guru Purnima, probably we'll all request you to play something for Guru Parampara or God, divinity, as Guru.
Sir, as a matter of fact, every note I play is my Guru's blessings. Any raga, anything I play, I pray to my Guru and everything is dedicated to him. Okay. Normally, a lot of people play Guru Leka in Ragam. Guru Leka, so I'll also play that.
Sure, sir.
Right now. Slip of tongue, it's Ragam Gauri Manohari.
Gauri Manohari. Very melodious, sir. Lot of your fans are watching. We are all feeling very blessed by Gauri Manohari. The beauty is they all are watching us, and Divine Mother is watching all of us. So if it is okay, I want to share a small story, a small, very small incident about Guru. Many years back, there's a great devotee of Sri Shirdi Sainath Maharaj. His name is Ekirala Bharadwaja. So he went to meet a guru who was living in a jungle. And he has a small hut. He lives in a jungle. So Ekirala Bharadwajaji went to visit him and see him in person because he's a great guru. When he went there, he offered, that Guruji offered, what you want to have? You must be hungry. He said, it's a small hut. What will you have? Sir, I don't have anything. I'll just have some milk. No, it's okay. You want to have idli, dosa, or puri? He was surprised. He's in the middle of the jungle. Why is he asking idli, puri, dosa, and all that? He said, no, it's okay. I know you like puri. He went inside the small hut and got a plate puri. Bharadwaji was shocked. How did he get it? So he had it. He stayed with him 3 days. All the 3 days, he goes inside the hut. They sleep outside, you know. But he will get some stuff. So one day when the Guruji went out, he went inside to see what is inside the small hut. How is he even preparing food? There is nothing in that except a small box and a couple of coins. The hut is empty. Guruji came back and asked him, did you check what is inside? Bharadwaja said, yes, sir, there's nothing. Please touch his feet. Tell me how you are producing all these things from this small hut. He said, this is called Guru Siddhi. The greatest Siddhi is thankfulness. There's no mantra. I do mantras, but at the same time, I am thankful to what I have. I'm thankful to Divine Mother. Even the slightest ego that comes is a block between me and God. Having at most devotion towards Guru, doing any sadhana, you will get perfection. So when you talk in previous episodes of Healing Mandolin, how your father wanted to train you to perfection, it's very inspiring, sir. It's very, very inspiring how your brother trained you. So as people who want to learn more music, you mentioned the value of discipline. Please tell us something about discipline, sir.
As a matter of fact, I'm not disciplined at all.
Who else can we learn better discipline from? How did you overcome that?
You need a guru like my brother and my father because, as I said, guru's role is very important in one's life. My father was very strict, as I told you. He used to wake me at 3:45, 4 o'clock in the morning until 7:30. Every day for so many years when I was young, I was very, very upset those days that he used to wake me early, but now I realize the value. So discipline is, of course, it is required to master any art.
Absolutely.
Guru's blessings is always important. So I strongly believe very important is Guru, follow your Guru, whatever it is. And don't, you should never underestimate or judge your Guru. A lot of people, due respect, they change gurus like 10 times, 20 times, and then 20 different gurus. If you are a good listener, you just need only one guru in any field. So you should basically trust your guru, completely give him the freedom to guide you. Then you will be guided through a proper route. That's what I believe. I may be wrong also, but this is what I believe in.
Well said, sir. Very well said. Following Guru is at most important. So that reminds me, even in spirituality, they worship Guru's feet, Guru Padam. Even today's this Guru Charanam. Guru Charanam is followed because Charanam is path. We follow the path where Guru has traveled. That's why feet are important. Even when they worship Lord Dattatreya, they keep padukas. In Upanishads, they said, Yasyam tarnadimadhyam nahikara charanam namagotram nasutram no jatir naiva varnam nabhavati purusho no napunso nachastri nakaram novikaram nahijanimaranam nasti punyam napapam no tattvam tattvamekam sahaja samarasam sadgurum tam namami. It is very difficult and it is not advised to analyze Guru, the Guru Tattvam itself is beyond any formula, caste, man, woman. The Guru Tattvam is Gukarasya Gunatito Rukarasya Andhakara Nirodhaka. The one who dispels darkness and brings light is Guru. Guru is one who holds your hand when you are falling off into deep well. It's okay. Holds hand and makes a person walk. Many, to all those masters, we want to say pranam, sir. They not only gave knowledge, they gave life to many Sadgurus, selfless Gurus. To all of them, I think today is a day to say pranams to them.
I would like to play one of my Guru's composition. It's in Ragam Charakesi. It's called Love Within.
Amazing, sir. Sir, long ago, Saptamaharshis, the seven sages, were in search of a guru. Apparently, first they went to Brahma because they had some questions. And then Brahma was busy talking to Mother Saraswati, joking. All the seven rishis thought, what is this? We are coming here to talk to this man. He's so busy talking to his wife and joking. He doesn't even have concentration on ignoring gurus like us. So how can he even answer our questions? They went to Vishnu. Vishnu was nicely lying down on Adisesha, and Lakshmiji is pressing his feet. They thought this man is even worst. He's addicted to services of his wife. How can he answer our questions? We are brahmacharis sitting here doing tapas for hundreds of years. They went to Shiva. Shiva was in Ardhanarishvara Rupam. He was dancing. They said, this is the worst of all. This man gave half of his body to his wife. So completely, is this uska sharir mein hosh bhi nahi hai. He doesn't even know what he's thinking, what he's doing. So he cannot answer our questions. Then the Saptamarishi is disappointed. They could not find a guru. They came down to earth. Where they were landing, Shiva saw all the story, what is going on. He stayed there. He appeared in front of them in the form of Dakshinamurti. When Dakshinamurti appeared, the moment they saw Dakshinamurti, the very instant they saw Dakshinamurti, they completely, all the doubts got dispelled. Dakshinamurti is only avataram that stayed for a fraction of a second. There's no discussion. Maunavyakyam Dakshinantam Vamadevam Nandivaham. He did not give any speeches, no clarity. People look at it. Visvam darpana drishyamana nagari tulyam nijantargatam pasyannatmani mayaya bahirivodbhutam yadhatasya. The way whole universe shows up in a mirror. If you put a mirror, whole city we can see in the mirror. Likewise, whole universe is in Dakshinamurti. Like all the doubts are cleared. So I thought today is the most auspicious day to talk about Dakshinamurti. We all pray to Dakshinamurti with a mantra on behalf of all of us in these COVID days for healing. Om Namo Dakshinamurtaye Prajnam Medham Prayachasvaha. Sir, over to you with some musical melody. Please enlighten us, sir.
When you said about Lord Dakshinamurti, can you hear me, sir?
Yes, sir. So clearly. As clear as Dakshinamurti speaking.
Kanchi Mahapriva is considered as Dakshinamurti avataram.
Yes, sir. Very fast.
And you know, two important gurus, God gurus are Kanchi Mahapriva and Satya Sai Baba. Anandji asked me, what is your experience with Satya Sai Baba Swami? It's a long story, but I put it very short. When I went to Parthi, I was a non-believer. Means non-believer in Satya Sai Baba. Because we come from following Kanchi Mat and Mahapariva was everything for us. In fact, Mahapariva is the reason I'm into music. When I first went to Puttaparthi, I still remember. I didn't even know that Swami was great or anything. I just went there just like a concert. But the transformation he made, it is amazing. That experience, it has to be experienced. It's more like food, the taste. It's amazing. With Swami, you have to experience. He knows how to take you, into his clutches and then protect you. He's one of the best gurus ever. This globe has his Paramacharya and Satya Sai Baba.
Beautiful,
and
sir.
Now I'll play Chandrasekhara Isha on Kanchi Mahapriva.
Beautiful, sir. Sir, even in the field of astrology, Guru, the Graha planet Guru is very, very important, sir. That's why a lot of prayers are performed to Satya Sai Babaji, Shirdi Sai Babaji, Raghavendra Swamiji, all these great gurus on Thursdays, because Thursday is Guru's special. Any planet that is aspected by Guru will behave properly because it is under the guidance of Guru. So whatever be the person's astrological problem, whatever be the state of mind of a person, on Thursdays, if they can perform any meditation, any sadhana, their life will be improved and they'll be blessed with great wealth also. Such is the power of Guru, sir. Such is the power of Jupiter. And Avadhaniji, Anant Avadhaniji just now asked a question. Maybe if you permit, I would like to answer that, sir. There is a question. Why we pray Guru on a full moon day? Guru Purnima, especially, why is it on a full moon day, Purnima day? The reason is, Purnima is the full moon. Moon is representing in the scriptures, Chandrama Manaso Jataha. In a full moon day, Manas, the mind, is in its full blown state. That's why when it is full moon, some people feel very excited. Of course, some people also go crazy. They say, you know, full moon day and dark moon day. So Amavasya and Purnami. Our mind is in extreme states. I know there is a particular family that came to me. Sir, every dark moon day, like Amavasya, my wife is fighting with me. Like, you know, is she possessed by some kind of a, you know, demon or devil? So, no, it's okay. No, that's not true. We gave a mantra and all that. You know, like a lot of cases, whether a wife or husband, full moon days, people go crazy. But the thing is, because moon on a full moon day, even the ocean tides come out. That day, the world is in it. Most state of consciousness and excitement. In that perfect state, if you take Guru, your ability to receive knowledge is also higher. That is first reason for Guru Purnima. Purnima is already full, mind is full. Second thing is, on the full moon day, Purnima, the moon is full and the darkness is removed because moon is full. That is the role of Guru. Rukarascha gunatito, rukarascha andhakar nirodhakah. Ajnanatimirandhasya jnananjana shalakaya chakshurunmilitam yena tasmai sri gurave namaha. That is the Guru. The Guru removes darkness. So the full moon removing darkness. So that is a perfect day where Jupiter and moon are working. Together they cause a Rajayoga called Gajakesari Yoga. Any person worshipping on a full moon day, Guru will be blessed automatically, whether they have it on in their horoscope or not, a Raja Yoga called Gajakesari Yoga. These are the three initial reasons for Guru Purnima. There are many, but these are the starting reasons. Sir, over to you. Over to some music, please.
No, somebody's Srilata ji is asking, what is the advice given by Mahapariva or Sai Baba? As you know, with Mahapariva, it is always silence. You have to understand, like, he is like Dakshinamurti. Even Swami always says, Swami chusukuntanu. That means Swami will take care. Indirectly or directly, they are saying that complete surrender to your Guru, they will take care. It can be a godly Guru or a human Guru, but as I always said, you should trust your Guru. And then fully leave it to him, he will take care. I'll play Sai Bhajan of Swami's one. Thank you.
Wonderful, Rajesh Gar. Once somebody asked, you know, Mahavishnu, it is none other than Narada, who asked a question to Mahavishnu, sir. What is the benefit of visiting Mahatmas and Gurus? Why all these people are crazy and going there? He mentioned, I think I told this story sometime before, but I like to repeat today, the benefit of visiting Mahatmas. When we see this video, sir, a small video, a beautiful video on YouTube, Annai Garu, Great C, Mandalin, Srinivas Garu, as a little kid, almost like Shanmukha, sitting there and playing mandolin. And great experts are on the sides. They're all playing Mrudangam and all that. They're all stalwarts in a packed concert hall. Can you tell us, sir, where that happened and enlighten us? Where Annai Garu, 12-year-old, I think, as a little kid, he was playing. Amazing. I think Bindu Malini or something he was playing. Can you tell us, sir?
That was in Thiruvayar. Thiruvayar.
Wonderful. Sir, who are the people around him and how did he get that kind of a blessing at that age? Please tell us more about it, sir.
I think he is the biggest example that there is Punarjanma. Because I don't think so anybody can play at that age. See, nowadays everybody says there's prodigy and all. But, you know, to play like that at 7 or 6, you definitely need to have been practiced in your previous Janma a lot. If not, nobody can play like that.
Absolutely.
Or a divine blessing. So he is the biggest example of to say that, to prove that there is rebirth. And to prove that there is divine presence always there. And that, sir, is my belief.
Beautiful, sir. Beautiful. Very, very beautiful. Sir, please play something. I will continue the story. Okay, sir, sure. So Narada went and asked Mahavishnu, what is the benefit of visiting Mahatmas? Vishnu said, oh, I'm busy right now. Why don't you go and ask this question? What is the benefit of visiting gurus? To that little ant that is there just born. So he went to the ant and Narada asked the ant, what is the benefit of visiting Mahatmas? The ant looked at him and died. He was like shocked. He went to Mahavishnu. You told me to go to the ant and I asked the question. The ant died. He said, oh, I'm so sorry. Just to go on, there is a beautiful baby elephant born. The elephant will answer you. So he went to the elephant. Narada went to the elephant and asked the question. What is the benefit of visiting Mahatmas and Gurus? The elephant looked at him and in the speech he said, thank you, and he died. Narada got a shock. Why the elephant is dying? He went back to Mahavishnu. I said, he was thinking in his mind, who is he going to send me next? He said, just now a prince is born in the fort to the king of that country. Go and ask him. He said, please, Narada said, Vishnu, I don't want to kill the boy. No, please go and ask. Narada went and asked the baby boy just born. The baby boy spoke completely like a scholar. Narada, thank you very much. You are the Mahatma. When I was an ant, you came and asked me a question. By your darshan, I got elevated and born as a elephant, from ant to elephant. From elephant, you came again asking me a question. I am born as a prince. Now you came and asked a question again. I attained moksha. I will rule this country and become a great chakravarti. You are the guru and you being asking me such question gave me the blessing. That is the benefit of visiting Mahatmas. So sometimes, we may not always be able to do sadhana yogis are doing. We may not always be able to spend years and years of sadhana. But by meeting them, the secret is a meeting. That's actually a very, very hidden secret in Sakshatkara. Today, I am able to see you, Rajesh sir and Praveen ji, and we are having the show means we all have a planetary configuration that is bringing us together. The great Mahamaya planned it, that we should all be together. So if there is a day in my life, I know some of you are very fortunate. I did not have the fortune. Some of you have met Mandalini Srinivasji. Some of you were taught by Srinivasji. Some of you, like Nanduji, were gifted mandolin by Srinivasji.
So you reach in your planetary situation, in your past karma, in your luck, you are fortunate to reach that spiritual and knowledge state already. That's the reason you are able to meet. If I want to meet, I cannot meet. If I want to play $1 million, I cannot meet Srinivasji. I cannot meet Kanchi Paramacharyaji. So we reach that level. So meeting is a very important event. I was in Calcutta once, sir, in Calcutta. I wanted to say, oh my God, Ramakrishna Paramahamsa room was there. I wanted to say, oh my God, Ramakrishna Paramahamsa, how can I see him? I was sitting there. He said, I cannot see him. Suddenly one old man came. There's a small gate. He put a glass of water on the gate and he opened it. The glass did not fall. Nobody seemed to have noticed. I was shocked. He took the glass and went in and put a deepam inside the Ramakrishna Paramahamsa's room in Dakshin Kali. I was shocked. Immediately, as soon as he finished the puja, I followed him. Sir, what is your name, Swamiji? He said, my name is Kedarnath Goswami. How did the glass did not fall down? He's not talking as if it is nothing. It is on a gate he put. And he moved the gate like this. The glass did not fall. It is against gravity, physics, everything I learned. I followed him. Please, I want to get the blessings of you. Okay, come with me. There's a huge line in Dakshin Kali. He took me into in the main temple from a back door. We entered the door. And directly Mahakali's statue is there. He gave a couple of mandara flowers. I said, I was having tears. Next time I went back, he was busy. Kedarnath Goswamiji is busy. I could never meet him. But I consider it as blessings of Ramakrishna Paramahamsa. Gurus are listening to us. Whoever you are listening to this show, wherever you are, your guru is listening to you. Your divinity is listening to you. You have the divinity within you. Antarmukha Samaradhyā Bahirmukha Sudurlabha. The inner temple is always open. Lighten that. That's all, sir, I wanted to share.
Since we are reached our time, it's almost time to close this session. Ravi Prasad ji has asked me, Rajeshji, please share your blissful experience with your guru and elder brother. The answer is there in it. It is blissful to be always with my brother. Every day was a learning experience. Every concert was a blessings and learning experience. All that experience only guides me in everyday's life. Thanks to my guru and brother. And thanks to Paramacharya and Satya Sai Baba. And there is a question for Madhuji and Praveen. Please tell us about your gurus.
Praveen ji will go first.
Yeah, after you finish, I'll play Swami Bhajan and we'll conclude this session.
Sure, sir.
Namaste, everybody. My first guru is my father, Narayan Swami, sir. And then I learned from Sri Muthukumar, sir, my guru from Bangalore, who I learned for more than 13 years with him. And currently I'm studying under Pandit Ramdas Palsukuleji from Pune. And my eternal guru is Satya Sai Baba. And thank you so much for having me here.
About me, I have learned from Mother Kanakadurga, is a guru. Then Chaganti Sarat Babu Garu is a physics lecturer who taught me logic and being reasonable. Kurtalan Swami Siddheswarananda Bharata Swamiji taught me Mantra Shastra. Great Sri Dr. Narayana Dutta Srimaliji taught me palmistry. Bandhakavi Rama Jogeswarawaji taught me how to look at time and Kalajnana. And many gurus like great Sri Radhika Prasad Maharaji, who lived more than 100 plus years in Vrindavan, taught me the value of devotion. At each feet of each of their guru, I learned a little bit. And the little bit I know, I want to improve more. I want to learn more music. And, you know, I'm fortunate with being all of you. Rajesh sir, can we please talk about also the online concert, mandolin healing, mandolin concert we are going to commence. So, definitely, I want to mention that.
As we always said, we are going through a lot of difficult times. Everybody knows, everybody aware, and everybody is also going through in one way or the other. So, we have taken initiative with the music lounge. They have taken initiative and we are supporting and doing a online concert digital experience to fundraise and support the artists who depend on everyday wages. Please do support and share. Thank you very much. Thank you, Madhugaru.
Thank you, sir. Mandolin is played. Everyone, we request you to stay a moment. We want to play the promo of online healing mandolin. This promo will also be put on YouTube and we'll share the link. But right now we are going to play it. Please see it and support the cause of helping the needful musicians in these tough times. The funds raised through this will be used completely for the benefit of the musicians who do not have concerts, and we are bringing the platform. Please enjoy this, share with your friends, and support the cause.